Welcome to the Fluid Faculty Center Small Form Factor PUM Image 36 Spotlight video. I'm Kevin O'Connor, Senior Principal Product Manager for Oracle Higher Education Development. Before we get started, please read the following Safe Harbor Statement. Thank you. We're excited to announce the release of the brand new Fluid Faculty Center for the Small Form Factor. We're delivering a new Faculty Center homepage, as well as a brand new Faculty Center tile for the small form factor. When you click on that tile, you will land on the Faculty Center menu, and the faculty member can choose from the following menu items: View My Schedule, Class Roster, or Grade Roster. If they choose the View My Schedule option, they are presented with a list of terms that the faculty member is assigned to one or more classes. I'm going to go ahead and select the fall 2025 term to review the instructor's schedule. I have landed on the instructor's View My Schedule page, and there are several new features that I will highlight on this page. And in addition to the links for the class details, class roster, grade roster, and exam schedule, we've added a new filter button that, when clicked, will enable the instructor to select how they view their class schedule. By class, which is the current view, or by day, which is a list calendar view. The instructor can also toggle on and off display all classes, or just display classes with students. We'll review all the links on this page in the next couple of slides. If the instructor chooses the by day radio button and after clicking apply, they'll be able to review their teaching schedule in a day by day calendar view. When the instructor clicks on the entry in the list view for the class, they are taken to the class details page. On the class details page, the instructor can review the status of the class, available seats, etc. In addition to that detail, any enrollment requirements, class notes, as well as any textbooks are reviewable for this particular class offering. When they click on the first tab, which is meeting details, they will be able to review the meeting days, times, room, etc. And if there's an exam scheduled for the class, it will be displayed at the bottom section of this page. Once the instructor has reviewed all the important information, they can click on the X in the upper right-hand corner of the page and return to the calendar view. On the calendar view, as well as many other main pages, the instructor can click on the action button, which is the circle with three dots. Under the action button, and this will change based on the page the user is on, they can quickly navigate back to the Faculty Center navigation, the class roster or the grade roster for this class. I've clicked on the class roster link, and I've landed on the list of classes that have a roster for the instructor and now can access the class roster of my choice. I'm going to go ahead and click on the social 100 row in my list, and I'll be taken to the class roster for that class. If configured or enabled on the Fluid Faculty Center setup page, which I will show later, for the small form factor, the faculty member will land on the brand new photo class roster. There are several new features on this page, the first of which is the data privacy link. This is now a fully configurable data privacy statement that will allow each campus to use their own terminology, as well as any data privacy policy statements that they would like to display. If the faculty member clicks on the filter button, they will have the choice to display students with different statuses: enrolled, waitlisted, dropped. The class roster is now fully configurable by clicking on the up and down arrows for larger rosters. The magnifying glass can also do a full search of the list. Notice the action button on this page is different than the previous page. As well as the ability to change classes from here, the instructor can return to the Faculty Center navigation, change classes, and then notify selected students. The faculty member can also click on the main row for each student and review all of the individual student details, including the student's photo, as well as send an email directly from this page using their mobile device native email program. The last link on the action menu is notify selected students. On the main class roster page, the faculty member can select individual students or groups that they would like to notify directly, and a new feature has been added on the notification widget to actually add attachments. This is a new feature, and an instructor can include a syllabus, assignments, special notes, etc. The instructor can also click on the send email link for each individual student, and that will invoke the native email device, whether it's a mobile app or on a PC. Returning to the My Schedule page, the faculty member can review their scheduled exams for an individual class, and this link will only be active if there's a scheduled exam for a specific section. The instructor can access the grade roster from multiple pages, including the main navigation page, class roster actions, as well as a grade roster link on the View My Schedule page. That link will only be active if a grade roster exists for that class section. These links will take the instructor directly to the grade roster for the class they've selected. After clicking on the filter button on the previous page, the instructor is taken to the grade roster filters page where they can review or change the grade roster type, whether it's a midterm or final grade, and if they want to view only ungraded students on the roster page. After clicking on the action menu on the previous page, the instructor is taken to the grade roster actions page. So, in addition to the links that I've talked about before, the instructor can now update the approval status based on their grading access, as well as do bulk grading for multiple students, which should be pre-selected prior to coming to this page. After reviewing the filters and actions, the instructor can review each student, and by clicking on the grade link in the active row for the student, they will be taken to the student grades page where they can enter a roster grade, review any requirement designations, add a transcript note, and the instructor can also open all sections and review the 360 degree view of the student. Let's go ahead and move on to the Fluid Faculty Center small form factor setup and configuration page. All of what you've just seen is fully configurable on the brand new setup page for the small form factor. Your institution has control over what functionality will be made available to the instructors, including View My Schedule, class and grade rosters, and how they would like to default how those classes are presented in the View My Schedule. The next section is the all-new, fully configurable privacy statement setup that has been delivered to allow all of our customers, whether they are domestic or international, to design and deploy a unique data privacy statement. You have the ability to add a new label, URL, as well as the privacy statements that are made visible to your faculty. The new photo rosters are configured here, as well as any of the pronoun settings that you would like to display. Your institution can control how many meeting patterns show in the default view when an instructor reviews their schedule, and what the message will display to expand or reduce the number of meeting patterns in that view. Also, set up here is whether you would like to display textbook. The last section is the class label options, and this is how you would like to show your faculty members in their schedule and rosters exactly what the class number and label should look like. Thank you for attending today's presentation of the new Fluid Faculty Center for the small form factor.